From Gatwick, he made the 1¾-hour flight to Girona before heading for the coast. His brief this time, to look at what's available when you decide not to stay in a concrete high-rise hotel.
All along the Mediterranean coast of Spain, this is the summer scene. Bodies on beaches. This, in fact, is Tossa de Mar on the Costa Brava. It was one of Spain's first holiday resorts, and when you consider what some of the others look like now, all skyscraping hotels and apartment blocks, it's a wonder Tossa's managed to stay in such good shape. But it has. It's small, it's attractive, and in one respect, quite unchanged.
As long as you avoid the peak weeks of July and August, you can turn up in Tossa without any reservations. The tourist office here will point you in the right direction.
That direction could well be towards the Plaza España and the Hotel Diana. It rates 2 stars in the local guide, but when they worked out the ratings, they don't seem to have taken elegance or history into account, and the Diana's got a lot of both. A room here with a private bathroom will cost you around £16 a night, low season. That's for 2 people and includes breakfasts. The hotel's right on the seafront, and its restaurants always busy, a good indication of any hotel's quality. It was built around 120 years ago as a private house, a grand private house to judge from the old-fashioned elegance of its public rooms. You don't get that style in a purpose-built hotel. It's a good place for the independent traveller to head for, the sort of traveller who gets to Tossa by way of Girona on a cheap air ticket. But Tossa has other options, simple guest houses called hostels, where you can stay very cheaply. It's a bit of a step up the hill to the one-star hostel Hecla, but you can enjoy the view when you get there. Want to keep your costs even lower? Well, then take your pick of half a dozen campsites in and around the town. The Polar's just 2½ miles away, along the road to San Feliu, with pitches for tents and caravans set among the trees behind its own beach. It's got an impressive range of facilities, among them a small supermarket, which carries a wide range of provisions for those who want to prepare their own meals. For many people, that's an essential part of a camping holiday. But for those who want it, there are a couple of bars which provide snack meals and a restaurant. The shower blocks, lavatories and washing areas were clean and well maintained, and the tennis courts, the table tennis and other sports facilities were in constant use. The beach is small and can get crowded, but nobody seems to mind that. As for costs, well, a couple with a car will pay £7 a night to pitch a tent, £9 for a caravan this spring.
So far, we've seen a modest hotel, a guest house and a campsite, all of them geared up for the independent traveller, although, in fact, that campsite is used by one of the British camping tour firms. But what is there here in Tossa for people who don't want to fend for themselves? What has it got to offer the package holidaymaker?
For a start, it's got hotels like La Palmera. Rated 1 star, it gives a first impression of being a bit frayed at the edges, in need of a little attention. But having stayed there myself, I can vouch for its friendly atmosphere. A package holiday here will cost from £161 per person this year. That's for 2 weeks full board in a room with private bathroom and includes your flights and a coach transfer from Girona Airport. I spoke to several guests when we filmed here last July. They all rated it highly, and several said they were frequent visitors. Another modest hotel featured in the package tour brochures is located right in the middle of Tossa. Rating 2 stars in the Residencia category, the Horta Rossell. It spreads over 2 blocks, one an old farmhouse, the other a purpose-built 4-story block. The rooms are simple, but they have private showers and lavatories. A 2-week package holiday will cost from £118 per person this year. That includes breakfasts and the flights and coach transfers. When we filmed here and elsewhere in Tossa, we met very many British holidaymakers. All seemed well pleased with the resort and their different accommodation. Tossa, they reckon, was a good value, low-cost destination. And let's face it, that's what matters most, whether you go there as a packaged holidaymaker or an independent traveller.